So, welcome to another special edition of the Get Off My Lawn Records podcast.
Get off my lawn!
We are going to unbox this Mother 32 for you longtime viewers. We did the unboxing of the Volca Kick, and quite controversial because we did that up at Cody's house and he didn't really have, like, we weren't able to plug in. So we recorded the little speaker. These don't have a little speaker. So I'm sitting here with Tom. This is Tom's, actually. Hi, Tom.
Good morning.
Is it morning?
It is to me.
Okay. Tom has let me actually open up his new Mother 32, which is pretty cool. Thank you for letting us do this.
Well, since I already have one, I figure, you know, the second one, it's not as big of a...
Not as big of a deal.
Yeah.
It should be noted, Tom is in many, many, almost all of the Freeform Fridays.
More than I should be? No.
You missed the Heart by Andrea ones because you had a thing.
Yeah. 90%-ish.
Yeah. And Tom's been playing with the Jazz Destroyers for quite a while. Just to get this out of the way, we have download cards for sale. So if you see us at the gigs, you can get these for $5. Otherwise, you can download directly through the link. But we do charge a little more online because those big tech snakes take so much off of the top. So let's get started, shall we?
We shall.
These were designed after Bob had passed, right?
That is my understanding.
Yeah.
Although I'm not a Moog. I say it old school. I'm old, by the way, in case anyone doesn't know. I'm not super familiar with the lore, but these did come out, I believe, after Bob's passing.
Okay. Yeah, I think Bob, the last thing he worked on was the Subfatty. Or
was it?
The Voyager.
I thought it was the Slim Fatty.
The Slim Fatty. That sounds right. I have a Subfatty. I like it a lot. But I don't know that we're going to have the real estate on this little folding table. So let's take a look at the box. On the side here, we have our design. They always do a nice job with these boxes, the logo and everything. The sides, what's your serial number on this one? 10258. That's pretty cool. So you got the same design on both sides. And then that little guy.
It's a nice box.
It's a really nice, that's why I wanted to do this. They do a really nice job with this packaging. So the way these open, what I like about Moog, and the way I know it's called Moog is because of the Moog Rogue.
And
I'm not British.
There you go.
That's where the Moog thing came from. It was all the Brits.
Oh. Well, my experience with the brand name was pre-internet, so no one knew how to pronounce anything.
Yeah. Yeah. Making fun of somebody for pronouncing something wrong just means they learned that word by reading. We should all do more of that. So let's open this up. So right here, this was a demo unit from Sweetwater?
Yeah, it was a demo and one that I got a scoop on from my sales engineer, whom I appreciate.
What artists need is an endless resource full of rough edges and dimly lit nooks and crannies that one can explore as one sees fit. The master himself. Very cool. So now let's lift open the top. So that's a little different than what we had with the Subfatty. So this opens up, and we're gonna have this is our manual.
And that did not come with the first one I got, by the way. So I don't know if and my first one was a demo. So I don't know if it's because it was just omitted because it was a demo, or because at that point in time they weren't printing those.
Probably the first one.
Yeah.
The one for my Subfatty, I'm about, it's on my queue of things to frame. It's going to go on the wall.
Ah.
You can register it, semi-modular, and that great big old classic logo. So let's get that out of the way. What else is in here? Oh, the actual manual.
Yes.
So that was like a quick start guide. And I always love the block layouts on these.
I've read for most of that, and it's pretty good.
Oh, God. That looks... It's all in English. That's a lot of information. So we'll have you play with this thing, because I might get a little lost. But you can... I'm sure you can download this.
You can, and a fair amount of it is dedicated to the operation of the sequencer, actually.
Oh, that makes sense. Do you know how to use the sequencer very well?
I know how to use it, and then if I don't use it for about 2 weeks, I have to go refresh myself.
Fair enough. We'll give it a try. So, yeah, but they do these block diagrams on the inside, and that's just so cool. Mother 32 is handcrafted with care by employee owners in Asheville, North Carolina. That's how you build a sustainable business. They came pretty close to the edge, right?
Yes.
Or did they actually go under at one point and then revitalized?
I want to say they actually went under, and that was the reason that there was the Big Briar audio, which was, I don't know if they went under or if the name was just bought and production ceased again. That would be something for somebody with more. Well, there's the Bob Moog Foundation.
Okay.
You know, and there's some videos. I think they even have a YouTube channel. They definitely have a website.
Huh. So somebody leave some comments on the video and we'll provide links. So here it is right here. I have never actually touched one of these.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
I'm really looking forward to playing with this. So in here's the synthesizer. We have some extra stuff in here. This is...
the power supply.
This is for the power supply?
Yeah.
So if we open that up, Tom likes to keep all these little baggies and stuff, so he's going to hate me because I'm going to actually take all these out.
Oh, so I don't care.
We open this up. It's a... That's for an American outlet.
Patch cables.
A little Moog patch cables.
Yeah.
That's pretty neat. There's this pen-looking thing. What's this?
I believe that's the calibration tool. That's the one thing that wasn't in the box other than the little fold-out quick start. That's the other thing that wasn't in the box on my first Mother 32.
Huh.
So.
I hope your Sweetwater rep gave you an appropriate discount for those two things being missing.
You know, I didn't occur to ask for it because I didn't know they existed until just now.
So. Ah. And then here we go. We have our... Oh, I'm just going to have to...
Just tear it.
I'm just going to have to tear it.
It's easier.
So it's a universal AC adapter. They do these... This is getting more and more common as we've gone to a global economy. In Europe, they would just have a little different...
Yeah.
This piece, and just slides in.
Well, I mean, they're following the cue of the mobile computing...
Yeah.
You know, because, I mean, everything there is transformer-based, so it's just a matter of connecting to the local standard.
That's a pretty good size power cable. And what else? Steal this Moog. Okay, don't steal it. But we might just send it to you for free. Details on the other side.
Oh,
really?
Neat.
Oh, it's your registration card.
Oh, we'll get it later.
And it's...
Now it's way under the table.
It's under the table, and the table's in the corner, so I'm not going after it. And then... Oh, look at this. This is a product catalog. I love this stuff. This is why I do these unboxings.
I love it, and yet all I do is feel sorry for the trees that died to create it.
Oh, that's true. Let's open this guy up.
It's very pretty.
Did you get the... So you got this with the other one?
I did not.
So this is other candy.
Oh, look at that.
So I don't... Did they discontinue my sub fatty?
No.
Sub fatty. Oh, 9, 10. 9, 10. That's my sub fatty. That's the 37. Too many knobs for my taste. I'm, of course, joking. And then... So it's just really hard to see, but that is the whole thing. And then on the other side is this really cool old vintage old logo Moog poster.
That is cool.
You need to frame this.
Yeah,
this needs to go
I think
up.
So. That's pretty nice.
Now you have two of these. This is definitely... So let's fold that back up. And maybe I'll fast forward through the fold up.
I think realistically now every Moog product should come with a card that says, So you were too impatient to save up for a Model D.
That's pretty funny.
Because really,
we all want a Model D. All right, so let's get the box out of the way. All right, so this is the Moog. So you got your two little wings to keep it suspended in the box. Those go away. Get these. I'll hand these to you for now.
All right.
And then I assume it was originally bagged up a little nicer than this. This is the demo.
One wonders, though.
Yeah. So look at that. God, that's pretty. I'm already getting a little bit of a headache just staring at all of those input points. That's pretty cool.
That's my only thing, right? The typeface is very small when you're over 40.
It's true. It's true.
It is, right? I mean.
And then you got a little one octave keyboard here to enter in your notes for your sequencer. And MIDI in. So where is the, so that's the side.
Yep.
Single audio out, quarter inch. So we'll hook that up. We'll see what this sounds like. And on the underside, does that serial number match the box? I think it does.
Yeah.
102.58. Very cool. And I'm sitting here staring at this. That looks like an imperfection, but that's actually the state of North Carolina.
I had no idea it was so blobby.
That's pretty cool. It's got these nice wood panel sides, and it just looks great. We've got this coming over from the board that Tom sold me. Tom, while I'm plugging this in, tell me the records that board was used on.
Well, it was used on a lot of demos, and it was for a little while. The first owner was Greg Martin of the Kentucky Headhunters.
I have no idea who that is, so, but leave me a comment.
Country rock. They're really just a rock band. Anyway, he's a friend of mine, and we're from the same geographical location of Central Kentucky, so the middle of nowhere.
Same as Hal Sparks.
Who?
Hal Sparks. I'm a big Hal Sparks fan.
Oh.
You should go subscribe to Hal Sparks on YouTube. He was Zoltan in Dude, Where's My Car? He's a stand-up comedian. He's got a progressive talk radio show. He's great.
Okay. Well, there you go.
So let's see. We want to keep our... I'm still figuring out what I'm looking at here. That's my total... That's my overall volume.
Yes.
Now, if I just push a button on here, I should get a note, right?
Hard to say. Apparently not. Oh, wait. Which channel are we in?
I'm on 3.
Okay.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. Crank out the sustain on that, the release. So decay should be way up, and then you'll get something.
Sustain
being
on.
Tom Hand. Yeah, so there we go. You have now figured it out.
Will it do pulse width modulation? Yes, it will.
Yes, it will, yeah.
Let's see if there's anything, if I just hit run.
It's just going to give you the same note over and over again. But the nice thing is you can actually play with that once it's running. You just sort of hit notes and go around and let it do things and play over it if you're bored. That's right. Instant gratification right out of the box. Or you can just drop it in an octave and start playing with the filter, right? Because that's what everyone wants to do.
Oh, that's cool. Oh, that's too much fun. So what we're going to do is now Tom and I, we're going to trade places. And and we're actually going to rack this thing. Well,
we're gonna mess with it a smidge, and then we'll rack it.
You're gonna mess with it, then we'll rack it, and then we'll mess with it.
Yeah, sure, why not? Well, right. I'll mess with it for like 2 minutes because
that's plenty. We should show everybody your phone.
I can do this because I'm old and can't see. Do you want to show the internet my rose gold iPhone 6S Plus?
You're so manly. So manly.
Chosen by my stepdaughter. So, which is good. She brought up a valid point. If I lose my phone constantly, and if I got one that was some color other than black, I'd probably be able to find it.
Well, at least now we know who wears the pants in the family.
Everyone wears pants. It's one of the rules.
Fair enough.
We got to wear pants. The sequencer, which I haven't done in 2 weeks, so we're just going to mess around with this a little bit.
Yeah.
But everything revolves around the shift key.
Okay.
I don't like screw this up because I haven't done this in a long time. But so I want to say that you actually do shift and reset and then shift pattern. And do I pick? Yeah, okay. So you can pick your pattern with the little step button.
Sure.
There we go.
Did you just do Dorian?
Pretty much.
Awesome.
So, let me see that. Right, so you got this going.
Well, let's make it make
sense. I know, we're totally. I'm probably blowing the meters right off right now, so.
Yeah.
There you go. What have you set up on this? There we go. Much better. So now we have something going. That's kind of good. It's not really good. It just is. Then you start playing with patch cables.
Go ahead.
I'm going to. I've set my phone down already. I already lost it, just like I said I wouldn't. So
it's behind you.
Okay, that's fine. So LFO. This labeling system is funny because the labels are above the patch points they represent.
Okay.
I keep forgetting that. Literally, I keep forgetting that. So I'm,
oh, that's cool.
So right, I'm doing the, I'm not playing it, so I can play what I'm doing. So that's the LFO triangle to the VCO mod. It's a nice sound, right? I mean, it's kind of got that classic-y synthy thing.
Turn up the LFO speed.
And then, yeah, so you get, and it's just, you're getting into ring modulator territory, right? So it's awesome. So there's that.
You'll have to program in on the run.
There's a YouTube link, and I'll send it to Don, where there's a guy who gets a tutorial on doing on the run on this.
Yeah?
So, yeah, so it exists.
We'll put a card up.
I'm trying to think. There's a big thing on here, other than the obvious stuff.
Actually, if you thumbs up right there, make a thumbs up, that we'll put a card right there for that,
okay,
for that tutorial.
So I'm going to take it out of the LFO triangle and then put it. There's the VCF cutoff, so the filter cutoff. And then
it's like almost 12.8.
I like that. Right.
Well, if you take it all the way to the extreme, will it go into the audio range?
Yeah, pretty much. Actually, it does.
Can you route that to pitch?
There is a way to route the filter to pitch.
No, I'm the LFO. Can you route the LFO to pitch?
You know, I don't know. I'll be honest with you. I don't try to do that. Sorry, I'm going to lean off.
Here, pause it. Pause it.
That's what that was going to be my guess, but then it's like, let's see if that works. Oh, God.
Now, if you can route the LFO speed to the pitch out, so KB out probably, which is the second from the bottom row, yeah. And then take that up to the LFO rate, which is the middle. Second column. Yeah, LFO rate. Right
there. Hold on. Oh, you know, that's why these cards are handy. You can actually see something.
There you go.
Oh, jeez.
Take that into LFO rate.
I can't find it. Oh, there it is.
Now change the rate of the LFO. But if you bring it up into the audio range, you're actually making frequency
right,
FM synthesis.
Doing FM.
In analog.
And FM does no great shakes, but I just gotta say it.
All right. Should we...
Because everything here is just, you know... And
what
we
else
can,
should we do?
We can... Whoa. It's a dying daily.
Destroy, destroy.
I know, right?
Yeah. Which LFO wave are you on?
Triangle.
Do the same thing with square. Let's hear all what right. that sounds like. So your L. Oh, that's weird.
And so we're not even getting to my favorite part, which is. I like a little noise. I like a little noise.
Can you do sample and hold on these? I see a hold. I just don't know.
I'm not sure. I did see a little patch where someone did like a sample and hold type thing, but it was a fairly convoluted ordeal.
I bet.
Say.
I bet.
You know, I can just... I'm going to pull all this out for a second.
Okay.
We're back to that. But... I'm trying to think if there's any neat tricks that we can do other than that. I tend to do a lot of noisy stuff because I like the noise. Because I like that sound.
Right.
I'm weird. So
that's pretty cool.
That's a general overview, so we should rack them.
Yeah, let's rack them. So what are we opening now?
We're opening the, I guess, rack. We're opening the actual, it has a word here, 2 of 3, 4, 5 words. Moog Mother-32, two-tier vertical rack kit. And I've been lusting after this for a while for no reason because, as you can tell by earlier, most of my time is spent interfacing with a stringed instrument.
Right.
But you know what? These are fun and... If you want to have something around that will get you in a different frame of mind and put you sort of a little bit out of your element, which is good for looking at things differently, these are great. So,
here, I'll take that.
Much more accessible than trying to build your own modular. Which is great. And, you know.
So this packaging, it looks like, is... considerably less care taken, but it's more of a commodity.
Yeah, purchase. this is a, as you can see, the instructions right on right here of how to whatever. It basically shows you how to put screws in. So,
hey, good thing we got a screwdriver on the Swiss Army knife. Huh?
It really is. So we're gonna take this box and try to not hit a camera.
Ooh.
What?
You might need something a little beefier. You got a
better screwdriver?
Yeah, you got your...
I don't know.
Check in that top drawer there.
I was going to check in the packaging.
Oh.
You Moog never
is,
know.
Moog is a cool enough company. They're hip
enough. They might send something that can actually do this.
So what was that?
They might not. This is I don't know.
It's just a bracket.
It goes between the two.
Okay.
So
got to keep them separated.
Yes. Here are the actual screws. I'm going to set these here.
Okay.
And then the side rails.
At least they, I mean, the packaging's a little cheaper, but they tried to package it right.
It's packaged right. I mean, it's metal. They could have really actually, and I'm not trying to be critical, they could have made this more environmentally friendly and still protected as well. But, you know, that's...
Hey, that, you know what? None of us are above some valid criticism from time to time. Here, I'll take that out of your way.
Thank you. So, a couple of rails, and we may be off to find a screwdriver, so I'm going to have to pause this for a second.
That's all right. All right, so we'll just, you know what we'll do? We'll fast forward through this, but let's bring in the other Mother 32. So we have...
I'm glad I got both power supplies, because the one I grabbed the first time was the wrong one.
Really?
Yeah, weirdly enough.
So we actually have two of these, and that is probably going to be my...
So yeah. This one's a little dirty. You can see it's been like sitting out and being on my desk. So,
well, and your desk is in an industrial facility. Here, you want to pass me that AC adapter? I'll plug that in.
Yeah. I think I like this setup better than the side-by-side deal, simply because the patch bays aren't side-by-side that way, right? The,
Yeah.
It'd be one thing if it was modular enough to where you could move the patch bay around, but you really can't. So having those patch points close to each other, you know.
It's a BFT. I mean, this is seriously cool.
This is enough synthesis capability for you to never run out of options realistically.
Yep. Let's just be gentle when we...
For not a ton of money.
When we do this, but...
Realistically, right? I mean, I'll never rule out getting a Model D if I suddenly, you know, fall into an ass load of cash.
But, let's be honest.
But barring that...
We're working stiffs.
Yeah.
I'm just knocking everything.
And who am I kidding? I still have to spend a fair amount of my time learning new stuff at work. I mean, that accounts for, you know, operating systems get revised and upgraded and have new capabilities. And, you know, people just take it for granted. Oh, you don't do anything. You're in IT. You sit around all day. It's like, no, it's like any other profession that's information-based is you have to do that whole continuing education, and you're responsible for doing it yourself.
Right.
So, you know, don't kid yourself.
Let's set this up. Let's see how this goes.
This is kind of awesome.
Let's just center that and straighten it out.
All right, that's pretty good.
Cool. I'm ready to bring the volume up when you are.
Okay.
So, ready?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
All righty. Testing. Is this thing on? Apparently it is. Yep, it's in. It's on. Yep, there's one. So we didn't save our sequence, and if you don't save it, power off, you lose it. You can save them though.
Let's make a new one.
So we'll make a new one, and we do the whole shift reset, which I'm pretty sure clears this. But and we'll do shift keyboard and shift record and. And the shift key does everything on here, but this is not really...
Typical Moog.
Moog.
Typical Moog.
Typical, yeah. And let's do some more of this shift.
shift rest. That seems good. So yeah, it's got a little jumpiness to it, right? So obviously these are not tuned to each other natively. See, for me, because I'm not necessarily a synth guy, I like the idea of just being able to
those are going to lose sync with each other.
I know. I don't care. That's just it. That's what I'm saying. I get that people would normally patch this and go, oh, you want to make these, like, run together.
Well, let's show everybody how it does that.
Let's do that. So.
I understand enjoying the drift.
I like the drift.
Press run.
Yeah, okay, now it's working. So hey. Now this one's... Now... Okay.
Now run the sequence on the low.
But I don't... But I've got... Okay, so that works. That was remarkably easy. You set it up exactly the opposite of what I was going to do, but it's okay.
Oh.
I was just kidding. I just got that one set up like this one, and then you're like, no, do this. I was like, and I thought, oh, I did something wrong. But we were just thinking reverse from each other. So
let's stop everything. Now that we got everything sick.
All right.
Oh, you know what would be cool?
What?
If we use the lower one to control something on the upper one.
And we can do that, by the way.
Yeah. That's the whole point of having two, right?
Right. That is totally the whole point of having two. So I'm going to... Let me just fart around here.
Yeah.
So what do I got going on here? So now I'm doing the LFO rate up here to the VCO mod because, well, it worked before. Oh, goody. Oh, my God. Let's not do that. Okay, we'll do that. So we'll go up here and control the LFO rate. Where's my wave?
Oh, you know what? Can you do gate out from the upper one into the LFO something on the lower?
I say it one more time. We'll do it.
So do gate out on the upper one? It's
those down low.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then let's go into like. Yeah, let's go into like LFO rate and see if it does anything. It's the middle second column.
Don't judge me, kids. Oh, you want to go into LFO rate from that? Okay.
Yeah. I'm just experimenting.
It's not really doing anything. It wasn't doing anything, but
you hear that? Unplug it. Hear it on the upper one. It's actually changing the upper.
Oh, it is. Yeah. Maybe I'll pull some of the noise out.
Oh, that's cool. Can we take the lower one down?
Okay. That sounds quite pleasant.
That's pretty cool.
That is cool.
It's not twisting knobs in the old jam. That's cool.
Yeah. Interesting.
That's really cool.
God.
So thanks for watching, everybody.
Yes, thanks for watching us learn on the fly.
Well, we're going to edit around that a little. And thumbs up for Moog.
Yes, thumbs up.
And subscribe. And give me the download card. Let's do another plug. The download card, the Jazz Destroyers live.
Got a frame on that one.
That's okay. I'm going to go on this one. The Jazz Destroyers Live is available on iTunes and Amazon, and I think it's even on Spotify, though. So go check it out. And thanks for watching, everybody.